Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The month of Sha’ban is a phenomenal month. It's the month before the month of Ramadan. And you and I know that for everything in Islam, there's a gateway that leads us to greater opportunity. So that as wudu leads you to adhan, and as adhan leads you to salah, so is the month of Rajab, so is the month of Sha’ban. They lead you to the grandeur and the completion of all the good that you seek in the blessed month of Ramadan. The Sahaba, they used to make the dua, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, bless our Rajab, bless our Sha'ban, and give us an opportunity to arrive to the month of Ramadan. May Allah allow us to arrive to the month of Ramadan with good health, with opportunity of worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, with a connection with our families and our loved ones, and a look to those who have departed from us, of mercy upon them, and asking Allah for their forgiveness, and may Allah send light upon their graves. Allahumma ameen. I wanted to mention three important elements of Sha'ban. The first of them is that the Prophet ﷺ used to fast in the month of Sha'ban for the first 15 days, up until the half of the month of Sha'ban. And this was a confirmed sunnah. He would fast a few days, not every day, but a lot of the first few days of the month of Sha'ban. And then he would cease fasting after the 15th day. So make that a habit, inshallah, if you're able. Second thing is that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in an authentic hadith. There are many unauthentic hadith about the half, the middle of Sha'ban. But in an authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah on the middle night of the full moon night of the month of Sha'ban looks into the hearts of his creation. And anyone who has not separated and has shown hostility to others, who hasn't separated from others or shown hostility to others, and is in good standing with the community that they live in, with their families and with their loved ones, except that they will be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now there's a subtle reason for this. The Prophet ﷺ is encouraging us to make amends before the month of Ramadan comes. So if you are in dispute with your wife, with your children, with your brother, with your sister, with your neighbor, with your cousin, with somebody overseas sitting under a mango tree, now is the time to fix it before the month of Ramadan arrives. The month of Ramadan is the month of love, the one where you seek the love of Allah by being spreading of love through humanity and through the society that you live in. You want to permeate the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala amongst society as a direct focus in bettering yourself, bettering your community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that easy for myself and you. Allahumma ameen. Third and final thing about the month of Sha'ban is that it is the month before Ramadan. Get excited, my dear brother. Get excited, my dear sister. The month of Ramadan, the month of forgiveness, the month of opportunity, the month of Allah's freedom of freeing us from Jahannam is soon to arrive. The month of fasting, the month of sacrifice, the month of patience, and the month of giving is soon to come. Now, there is a classic rookie mistake that people make, that they hold on to their wealth in this moment and they say, Ramadan is coming, sadaqah has to be better in Ramadan. But that is not how it is with Dhul Jalali wal Ikram, the one of all might and generosity and nobility. Ya akhi, ya ukhti, if you have wealth that you wanted to give in charity, and in your heart, this is something that's going to be for charity, and you're holding on for 30 more days for the month of Ramadan, I advise you against that. Give some of it now. Give some of it in charity now, because nobody can guarantee for me an hour or a day or a month from now. Give as a token of Allah, towards as a token to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to allow you to reach Ramadan, to give more in Ramadan. And don't ever feel that Al-Kareem, the most generous Allah, is going to receive from you this generosity and charity that you will care for others with and deprive you of giving more in the month of Ramadan. Wallahi, it's a date that can equal the size of a mountain if the sincerity and purity is of heart. Don't look at the amount and don't look at who or how you are giving or how you will give later in Ramadan. The one who gave you now to give is the one who will provide for you to give later. Don't hold back. The month of Sha'ban is a blessed month Allahumma ameen. Your brother Yahya Ibrahim, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.